When I beheld the shattered remnants of our home, I knew deepest despair. The inhabitants of these 14 fragments were feeble, frail, and foolish, oblivious to their imperfection, ignorant of their past. Malformed creatures thrashing blindly about, pitiful, disturbing, depressing. So, we took it upon ourselves to rejoin the worlds. But in our eagerness, and I confess our ignorance, we erred and made a useless void of the 13th. It was only afterwards that we discovered a connection twixt source and shard, a flow of energy that maintains elemental balance. And thus did we arrive at our time-honored modus operandi.
From a purely Asian standpoint, it could be said that what you seek to do is only logical. But that would be to ignore the immeasurable destruction wrought with each rejoining. You have murdered millions, and this we cannot condone.
By your fragmented existence, you continue to give rise to tragedies far crueler than any calamity. But yes, moral relativism and all that. Case in point, I do not consider you to be truly alive, ergo, I will not be guilty of murder if I kill you. Oh, don't look at me like that. You, for whom I have only the highest expectations. A vaunted hero of the Source, 7 times rejoined. Long have I awaited one who might brave a path of lesser tragedy. A resilient soul able to endure the necessary pain. I dare to... So, finish your task and slay the Light Warden. Make proof of your usefulness, and then we may speak again.
Forgive me, my lord, but this could not wait.
Speak freely, Captain.
Our informant in Colusia sends word of unusual activity in Yulmor. It appears their forces are entrenching themselves at key points throughout the city, making ready for an attack, by all indications.
An intriguing use of resources. I rather doubt Lord Vorthry is concerned for the safety of his citizens.
You think he's harboring the Light Warden inside the city walls? Even if he does have some means of controlling the Sin Eaters, wouldn't that be a little risky?
Risky or not, if there is even a chance the Warden is hiding there, we will need to act fast. The longer we wait, the better prepared the Yulmorans will be.
Agreed. See to your preparations then and make for Colusia. God's willing, this hunt will be the last. Let us see it through to the end.
We should begin by assembling in Wright. There we may assess the situation in Yulmor and decide how best to proceed.
Thank you. Thank you.
Strange. By their behavior, we may safely assume that they are under Vorthry's mind control. Yet the extent of the effect seemeth to vary dramatically between subjects. It is far too pronounced to be attributed simply to the vagaries of innate magical resistance.
Curiouser and curiouser. We met with no trouble en route. My thanks for securing the way. But given the state of the townsfolk, I see we were never in any danger of being recognized.
What can you tell us from here?
I sense a powerful eater in the uppermost reaches of the city. But there's something different about it. Its light is impure. We need to get closer.
Oh. Kaishir, what are you doing here?
While I was scouting the area, I noticed a suspicious figure skulking about. So I accosted him, only to have him call me Alfino. I thought it best to bring him along.
You see, that informant who's been feeding secrets to the Crystarium, it's me. See, after you saved my life in Yulmore, I thought about going somewhere far away, but I couldn't just leave, not without paying you back. So I decided to stay here, keep an eye on things. And whenever I spotted something strange, I shared it with your friends.
That took no small amount of courage. Well done.
I assume you saw what happened here.
Right, so an airship flew in a bit ago. And not long after, Vorthry starts ranting and raving. You could hear him from all the way out here. Geezer was doing his nut, shouting and screaming like someone had nicked his pie.
It is like the airship bore the soldiers sent to thwart our efforts in Armoring.
So eventually the yelling dies down, and then this hot, sticky wind comes blowing through. Now that's when everyone went funny. Not everyone but me. Well, me and a couple of newcomers, though even they started mumbling about Vorthry after a while. Not as bad as the rest, mind you.
Newcomers.
There's something I need Reen to see.
This was among the town folks' food stores.
Oh, that's just Bill. You almost doze his stuff out.
No, it couldn't be. I know what it is. It's Sin Eater. Meal is made out of Sin Eater.
So it is. In limited quantities, it may have little effect on an average individual. Yet if one were to consume it regularly, over a period of several years, I suspect it would do far, far more than merely nourish the body.
That Vorthry wieldeth power over Sin-Eaters is known. Could it be that those who partake of their flesh do thereby render themselves susceptible to his influence? It would serve to explain why the town's newer arrivals succumbed less quickly than those raised on a diet of meal.
He's been rounding up Sin Eaters and feeding them to people, altering them mouthful by mouthful, all to stop them answering back. There are desperate souls out there killing themselves to escape turning. This is unforgivable. An atrocity!
These Sin Eaters. What if they are not simply rounded up? Do you remember what we were told when first we came to the city? Many enter, but none leave. Let us put an end to it, to this paradise built upon the bones of the poor. Vorthra's deeds are beyond justification, beyond forgiveness. Evil.
It's highly probable that the Light Warden is waiting for us somewhere in there, and I'm all for going after it. But our enemies know our faces. They know that we are coming, and they will not let us through without a fight. Like it or not, the time for stealth is past. Now, my friend, if you would be so good as to lead the charge.
Thank you. I can feel it. A dark presence in my domain. Ah! It's them! The villains who would sow chaos in my perfect paradise! Keep them away from me!
Long live Lord Vorthree.
He would use his own people as shield. This area is older than Gatetown. There are bound to be far more civilians under Vorthree's command. But they do not act of their own free will, and we must not harm them.
As if we ever would. Press on with Alphano. We'll hold off the civilians and join you as soon as we can.
Thank you. You will find my master in his chamber. But only should you kill me this day, and you will not. You may think me under his spell, but I uphold Lord Vorthry's ideals of my own volition. Man is an inherently flawed creature. In his vain pursuit of righteousness, he but sows the seeds of future conflict. Thus have I chosen to place my hopes upon he who has transcended men, upon he who is unbound by the vagaries of conscience. But enough talk. I am a soldier, and you are my enemy. Come! Let us settle this once and for all!
gift for you.